Hello, my name is Alexander Medvedev, and together with my colleagues from Genex and Atlas, we present you GRAPE, Genomic Relatedness Detection Pipeline. Since the rapid emergence of genetic testing market, the DNA relative matching drives personal genomics. All major personal genomics companies provide this service. But despite the availability of scientific information and the accessibility of relevant tools, assembling a DNA matching pipeline that reliably operates on real-world genotypic data requires significant amount of research and significant amount of development resources. Other companies usually spend at least a year to assemble such a pipeline. That's why currently there are no end-to-end solutions for relatedness detection and genomic data that is reliable and accurate for both close and distant degrees, combines necessary pre-processing steps to work with diverse data sets, and which is ready for production integration. So in collaboration with Atlas, a genetic testing company operating in the UK, Russia, and Japan, we developed and tested GRAPE. GRAPE is a pipeline that can be used by other companies to do DNA matching and to build some products around it. It also can be used by research groups to detect relatives in GWAS datasets and infer causal disease variants with a greater accuracy. So in a nutshell, we are predicting relationship degree for a given pair of samples using their genetic data. Every person inherits half of each of his parents' DNA in chunks. Then some of these chunks will be passed to the next generation, possibly broken in the process called recombination. If two people have identical chunks of DNA inherited from the common ancestor, they are relatives, and these chunks are called IBD segments. Close relatives will have more identical chunks with higher total and average lengths. Therefore, we can predict relationship degree from that information. The pipeline implements best practices such as using a workflow management system SnakeMake, Docker containerization, GA4GH standardized task execution service, and CI/CD with automatic testing. GRAPE requires only a single VCF file as input. It is also able to download and check the integrity of reference datasets if needed, and it is able to perform a comprehensive data preprocessing because real-world data is often bad and heterogeneous. Then GRAPE performs an IBD inference and assigns relationship degrees using ERCA. It is worth to note that GRAPE has modular architecture that allows to switch between tools, but we recommend IBIS as IBD inference tool because it is very fast, can work with unfazed data, and shows reliable results with little false positives. So let's dive a little deeper into preprocessing. Here you can see the seven main steps of preprocessing. In essence, we remove all indels, we remove all rare SNPs, we check for strand DNA SNP ID mismatches, we remove all suspicious samples because they can corrupt our results, and we have optional phasing, imputation, removal of previously imputed SNPs, and optional lifting from one genome assembly to another. And then let's talk about results. To check the accuracy of our pipeline, we simulated a few pedigrees using unrelated individuals from 1,000 genomes genotype data and PetSim simulation software. On the left, you can see how well our pipeline detects relatives with a strict control for false positive rate. On the right, we relax our parameters and get a higher recall for degrees from 7 to 11 with some degrees in precision. This decrease in precision can be seen here. The rightmost column shows the false positives in the case of relaxed parameters of IBD inference and relationship degree estimation. But if we use a strict parameter set, we have no false positives, so the pipeline can be very reliable. Then we compared GRAPE across CV Stripes. Stripes is the only open source solution with some preprocessing and relatedness inference besides GRAPE. However, Stripes lacks many preprocessing options. It requires face data because it uses germline and it does not allow easy control over false positive rate. And on the left, you can see that recall is very high even for distant degrees, but there are a huge number of false positives for these distant degrees, and basically TRIBES predicts almost every pair of sample as relatives in our simulated data set. In the end, let's discuss a few more technical details. There is a sample from the main GRAPE report. It shows king degrees and kinship if king was invoked. GRAPE also produces ERCA confidence intervals and some IBD segment statistics, and output of every step is kept on the disk and every run is fully logged. Next, performance. So our pipeline is fairly fast, and it can work with the data set of size of 10,000 of samples or more in a sensible amount of time. And adding kink as an option for close relatives does not hurt the performance significantly. So thanks for your attention. We welcome you in our GitHub repository and support chat, and also we have a comprehensive white paper, and you can find the link to it also in our GitHub repository.